6.43 miles, 7 minutes, 55 seconds per mile today, running in the New Balance Fresh Foam Beacon. Had an absolutely lovely time out there. It was a little bit damp, but a little bit warmer than normal, and just absolutely enjoyed running on the run commute home. Was able to run in some tights and shorts rather than the kind of running pants that I've been running in. So it was a little bit it was nice to get out there with a little bit less of a layer on. So really enjoying it. But on the one hand, I was kind of wishing it were colder and wishing it were snowier and more gross out for some reason. And I think that's because I'm almost at 100 miles in the Hover CGR mid. But before I get to that point, I want to make sure I get some really cold or some really snowy miles in there. So that way I can have some kind of data to report back to you guys on for the intended purpose of that shoe, which is to run in wintry conditions, not, you know, 37 degrees and foggy. So I'm kind of holding off on that. I've even got another pair of shoes, a winter shoe that I'm very eager to get into. I think you guys are gonna be pretty excited about that review. But if it's not cold, what's the point in kind of getting that shoe out yet? So it's been sitting in my house in a box for like a week already and just waiting for the right moment. But on the other hand, I know that the winter is really long here in Chicago and there's gonna be plenty of really cold days. There's gonna be plenty of really snowy days. And by the time we get to like the beginning of March, I'm so sick of it. So I'm trying not to like rush into like the super harsh or extreme conditions, because that's certainly coming. And it's one of those things that I find myself as a parent doing that all the time and trying to pull myself back and hold on and not rush things so much. It's really easy to do with kids when you have kids. To think, oh, I can't wait until they're out of diapers, or I can't wait until they're in preschool, I can't wait until they're in kindergarten, because then, you know, and then you always have this idea of, because then all this great stuff will happen, or it'll be easier, or things will be simpler, or I'll enjoy things more. But, you know, that kind of makes you forego the present and what's right in front of you and how good things are right now for the hopes of something that's going to come later. And so what my wife and I constantly remind ourselves is enjoy right now. Enjoy the moment where one of my daughters still is in diapers and my other daughter is in first grade and reading and learning to love math. She's starting to draw her own comic books, which I think is awesome. I mean, mostly she's just copying other things that she sees, but that's the first step. First you mimic and then you iterate. And so it's really exciting to see that process. And my wife and I are especially trying to enjoy and relish the moments now while we have them and not try to fast forward over anything, which is something that's really easy to do this holiday season with the hustle bustle. You're just trying to get through the holiday season. A lot of people, I hear them kind of saying that, and I can understand that sentiment, but just want to slow down for a minute and just sit and enjoy. Not sit literally, because I can't sit still, but sit and enjoy. But before I go, I want to talk about today's charity runner. Today's charity runner for the day is Tamara Perry. She's going to be running the 2019 Chicago Marathon for PAWS Chicago. PAWS is a no-kill animal shelter, and its mission is to find permanent homes for shelter animals. And so I've donated $5 to her cause, and I'll post a link in the description for her fundraising page in case you would want to join me. Thanks so much for watching, everybody, and I will see you guys tomorrow.
Yo, what's going on?